professor Fabrizio Ferrandi for the high-level synthesis tool is in the room. We just gave the tutorial this morning, so hopefully you attended also that. And you know what I'm going to talk about, which is like motivating the workforce. So obviously data science algorithms, approach, frameworks, they keep evolving. That's an artificial intelligence world now, right? And we know that domain-specific accelerator are kind of the only way to keep increasing performance in type energy constraints. And like all the accelerator that exist today are really typical hardware process, right? Find a pattern that you can accelerate, iterate, new application, find another pattern. There is a productivity gap here. And instead, like in the world that we are now, the actual algorithm designer wants to have an opportunity to take and design its own custom accelerator. So. The reality is that we need the tools to quickly transition from the model, machine learning model or data analytics program down to the chiplet implementation. Our solution is the SODA synthesizer. It's a modular, multi-level, interoperable, extensible, open source hardware compiler from high-level programming framework to silicon. So compiler-based because it has a front-end that is based on MLIR, it's called SODAOPT, and it's compiler-based because the back-end is based on state-of-the-art high-level synthesis tool, PandaBamboo. We also support Coarse-Grain Reconfigurable Array Generator, still open source, OpenCG Array. I'm going a little more into the detail of Bamboo in this presentation. In all cases, we generate a synthesizable variable, and targets can be both FPGAs or ASICs. The beautiful thing is, since this is all compiler-based, obviously, design space exploration is changing compiler optimization passes and parameters, right? And you can build your own design space exploration algorithm in this way. And there are a few references if you want more details, obviously. In 10 minutes, it's difficult to go through all of it. The front-end is SODAOPT. It's based on MLIR. SODAOPT stands for Search, Outline, Dispatch, Accelerate, and Optimizer. It's based on MLIR, as I was saying, because it's also used now in a lot of high-level machine learning tools. Like TensorFlow runtime, Onyx to MLIR, PyTorch to MLIR. We support those lower to linear algebra in MLIR and then start with our optimization. You sort of does the partitioning and the optimizations of the snippets that you partition and you want to accelerate. And also generates, that's the other beautiful thing of MLIR, is that you can you generate LLVM MLIR or runtime calls, and you can generate also all the glue logic to control the accelerators from the host. It's open source, that's the link. You can find also the tutorial from this morning, I guess. The backend, in particular the HLS backend, is PandaBamboo. It's a potentially now, at least in terms of development, the only open source high-level synthesis tool remaining that is complete in a sense. Key features that we added during the years, parallel accelerator support, modular high-level synthesis, and support to target ASICs with open source tools. And obviously, we want to verify whatever the high-level synthesis tool does, so there is a significant part that is devoted to generate automated testing and verification. It's modular. We also support commercial tools, but today we are talking about open source, right? The LLVM IR, obviously, you can feed that to Vivad HLS, and we have numbers to prove it. But why an HLS backend? And why loop going through progressive lowering? Well, maybe you with HLS, you are not going to get the fastest solution possible, especially if you want to do true lowering. But if you have a good HLS engine, you can still deal with a general solution and generate an accelerator. And you can provide opportunities, right, also for finding specialized patterns and create custom accelerators. We use that, for example, to do the support for multi-threaded accelerators. And with respect to the other solutions that use HLS, right, we do. We keep going through progressive lowering, which is like how a compiler should do, right? It's more elegant, and you don't need to raise and lose information from the fact that you are writing back something in higher level. And again, as I said, new optimizations are compiler passes, and you can devise design space optimization problem right as a compiler design space optimization. Couple of words on the ASIC target in particular. We also tested with commercial tools, but we regularly, and that's also the focus of our tutorial, use the OpenRoad suite, both for with the OpenPDK 45 nanometers and the ASAP 7 nanometer cells, so that you can really evaluate your algorithms from the high level implementation down to the results provided by OpenRoad. And Bamboo has a feature through a tool to characterize the resource library, depending on the target technology. And it's used for both FPGA target and OpenPDK and ASAP are provided. This is just a list of the optimization that SOADOPT supports. I'm not going too much into the details through them. The key information is that we do optimization for both memory and the computational intensity before, once they are the code snippet that you want to accelerate is separated from the rest of the application. And the memory optimization are obviously very relevant because you can localize things and then work together with Arabic synthesis tool to add buffers, for example, or multiple memory ports. To demonstrate the flow, there are a few numbers with Polybench with ASAP 7 nanometers, but probably the nicest thing is this picture, right? we partitioned the LNet and then this is generated with an NAND gate, FreeBTK 45 nanometers, and you can see the version that are not accelerated and the version that are accelerated with the optimization from SOADOPT. Obviously, it's visually is nice. The optimized solutions are bigger, but they are also faster. And I think I have the number. They are faster. And quickly going through in the last couple of minutes, a couple of research opportunities. Obviously, this is the open source design automation workshop, the open source ecosystem, right? I hope that you quickly saw how SOADOPT right now demonstrate that open source tools can seamlessly integrate, right? Obviously, I worked on Bamboo, but we developed the SOADOPT on top of it after. And we use OpenRoad regularly. So there is a great opportunity to do this, right? And you can also integrate with commercial tools. Actually, with Professor Andrew Kang, we had a special session in ICAD talking about that. And that's another opportunity that with open source tool we have that before was not available. There is significant opportunities to support intellectual property and IP blocks. There are opportunities in supporting prototyping platform and FPGA generators. I think also Professor Gallardon had a talk today on OpenFPGA, right? So that's another opportunity. You can configure even the FPGA or the embedded FPGA that you're going to generate. Yeah, one example of a platform, for example, is the embedded scalable platforms from Columbia University, where we are working, right, with Bamboo as the open source tool. And other thing, this is a compiler. So profile-driven synthesis, you can, especially on the memory part that I was talking about, you can take optimized instrument on a host and then regenerate the architecture that is optimized for it. And I have 1 minute, but I need to flash this. If you didn't understand already, it's all open source, it's all available. There is the whole tutorial. You just take the picture, go visit, try the tool. But yeah, that's the SOADOPT synthesizer. We implement an end-to-end silicon compiler, compiler base for the generation of domain-specific accelerators. So hopefully, it's a first step, right, in creating this ecosystem of open source tools that can go from my level specification down directly to the hardware. And I'm happy to answer any question. Thank you.
much, Antonino. Also, you met your 10 minutes requirement perfectly. So, we have time for questions.
Thank you. So, I did not really understand how the standard cells should be pictured in the department.
This one?
Yeah, so can you elaborate a bit more?
Oh yeah, so this is just an example on how we do the partitioning, right? We were tasked, in this case, we were tasked to kind of generate chiplets out of this network, right? So what we did was using MLIR, we can do partitioning of the specification at the different granularities. We decided, I mean, it's just a simple thing, right? We decided to partition operator by operator. And then we went through the optimizations of our MLIR tool to optimize the different accelerators for each of the operators. But like, this is more, again, it's visually nice. The complete study also looks at how you kind of actually do the operator fusion, right? Because sometimes this is not convenient. But like, this was kind of a nice example to show end-to-end synthesis. Suppose that then you want to attach this with chiplets, right, with a chiplet interface. That's a simple pipeline that implements the model.
Okay, and thank you for your interesting work. It's not fully clear to me yet to what extent you focus on generating customer hardwired accelerators, let's say, versus fully programmable flexible accelerators, which really did require some form of compiler generation as well, to which you need to be implemented at the end.
So, yes, I don't have the right picture here, but like the main focus of this is fully custom accelerators, right? Use the MLIR tool, this one, this is a little better, use the MLIR tool to partition the specification at different granularities, right? If you look at our tutorial, we can do operator by operator depending on the die rate of MLIR that you choose, or insert a specific part of our SODA dialect to decide where to do the partitioning. And this can be obviously automated. Then, though, MLIR has a wonderful thing, that one of the lowering target by default is a runtime, right? You can define your own runtime. So that generates the glue logic for instead the microcontroller.
The accelerator is a fixed function, but you can hook it up to
this fixed function, obviously with high level synthesis, right, you can even write your kind of changing adaptable accelerator in C and then get it converted. Is efficient? No, not always, but.
Thank you.
Any more questions? I saw you first. Hi, thanks a lot for the talk. I would be interested in how you represent parameters in the finalized design, so network parameters.
For the machine learning model?
Yes.
Parameters can be either constant or can be loaded from the memory. One of the things that we are studying with actually accelerator where you can change the modality, right, is if they need to be input stationary, or you want something that is out stationary and you need to stream in the weights. They are stored in memory in our model, right, and then brought in into a local DRAM before computation.
Thank you. So, thank you for my question regarding the result that you presented, that you have 4x area increase on 15x speedup. Is it because the focus of the optimization is on speedup?
Yes.
So is it possible to do some multi-constant optimization?
Yes. So I don't have the slide here, but one of the things that you can do is obviously explore set which parameter you want to meet, right, and then perform like the SODA optimization passes trying to meet those constraints. It's not completely finalized yet, but we are adding a design space exploration engine in Python where you should be able to implement your own heuristic, right, to do also the exploration, changing the parameters.